Attention NBA, the following is a declaration of war on behalf of Sever the Bond from Nets Republic. From Nets Republic, I would like to declare war on everyone in the league. It's over. It's done. It's a wrap. Your personal opinions on how we got here aside, the situation has handled itself. Kyrie Irving is now officially able to play in home games. The mandates have been lifted. Kyrie's back full time. He will make his debut at our next home game. It's done. I'm not here to talk about how we got here. I'm not here to talk about who won. I'm not here to talk about who was centered out, who was isolated, who was picked on specifically. None of that. I don't care if you're Bing Bong. I don't care. This is a declaration of war on the rest of the league. Because now that we have a full-time Kyrie Irving, along with a healthy Kevin Durant, and Ben Simmons might be coming back sometime soon, it is over. Now, there were some question marks in the beginning of the year, even when we had Harden, because it was, oh, but what if Kyrie's not there and blah, blah, blah? It's done. It's over for you. There were questions of could we get it done because all three of them were not out there. But when all three of them were, when we had scary hours with Harden and Kyrie and Kevin Durant, it was over. None of you knew what to do. Did you see what we did to the Bulls? None of you stood a chance. But there were questions when there were only two of them. Would Harden care enough to contribute to a W? Would Kevin Durant be able to carry a one-legged Harden? What if Kyrie wasn't legally able to be there and it was only some weird combination of things? It's over. Because with just Kyrie and Kevin Durant in a full-time capacity, we only have one game plan. When you add in the eventual Ben Simmons, the game plan doesn't change. It's not like we have to try to figure out shots for him. He's just coming in to play defense and pass the ball. What I'm trying to tell you is that the game plan of Kevin Durant and Kyrie Irving, the 7-11, whatever you want to call it, it is the game plan. It's not, oh, he's not here, we can't build off of this next game. He is here permanently. This man is back. 7-11 is here, and it is our constant game plan every single night. There's no adjustment of, oh, he's not there, so now we got to see what Patty Mills can do. Every night, Kyrie Irving's going to be there. It doesn't matter who we play. Now, obviously, if we play the Raptors, all this goes out the window. But outside of that, it doesn't matter who we play. Kyrie will be there. So even if there's no Ben Simmons at any point this season, Philly got to see us again. Miami got to find a way to stop Kyrie and Kevin. Last time I checked, Kyrie was sending Giannis and his brother to the shadow rim in game 4 before he had to purposefully take him out. No one can stop us. It's done. My only reservation was he wasn't able to play. But now that he can play, it's over. It's over. This is a declaration of war on the entire league. Dust off the Kyrie jerseys. It doesn't matter anymore. It really doesn't matter anymore. Because now that he can play every game, you're done. You're cooked. Finito. It's done. That little voice in the back of your mind that's saying, but we really need business. Silencio, Bruno. It's done. This is everyone's final warning. Find shelter, pick up someone in the free agent market, go see if Jamal Crawford will come back and say, oh, I was just kidding on some Tom Brady. Because you're gonna need everything. This is our last chance. Everyone is here on 1 year minimums to get this done. This is our last chance. And they done gave us Kyrie back full time. I would say RIP, but I don't want you to rest. I want you to suffer in that casket when you watch us hoist up the trophy. I want you to suffer. So SIP, suffer in peace. I'd say something else, but this is Nets Republic and not my main channel. Good luck, blankety blanks. You're gonna need it.